First up this morning, the Milwaukee Public Library has 14 locations and, get this, almost 3 million items in circulation. So what do you think were the most popular books checked out last year?
Joining us now is the head of Milwaukee Central Library. It's Rachel Arndt with some of those titles. Good to see you.
Good morning.
Good morning. It's been a while since we've seen you.
I'm glad to be back.
You've been busy with the Dewey Decimal System.
Yeah, I've been keeping myself busy tracking all these books.
First, before we kind of get into it, let's talk about, before we go to the most popular, just give us an overview of why people should be a part of the library.
Well, number one, you're going to get all of the bestsellers, but you can also go back and revisit the classics of your childhood. So if you never actually finished that book for your English class in high school, now's a great time to go back and do that.
Yeah.
There's so much at the library, too. And you guys keep up with technology, which a lot of people maybe don't know, with audiobooks and tons of other things, not just your standard books, but books are great, too. So let's talk about the most popular books that have been checked out at the library.
All right. So I have five selections with us. The number one most popular book in 2019 was Becoming by Michelle Obama.
Yes. Really? Okay.
You know, a story of women's empowerment, coming from humble beginnings. So it's a really inspirational tale, no matter what your politics.
Yeah, and she was here. And so a lot of people saw her, too. I feel like a lot of people wanted to read her book as well before they went and met her or saw her, too.
Right. She had that book tour. So that really helps drive some of the popularity. Once you hear that everyone else is reading that same book, you want to know the story, too.
Oh, for sure. It's talkable also. Okay, so what's the second most popular?
The second most popular is Educated by Tara Westover.
Okay.
It is a harrowing story of a young woman basically growing up off the grid. She was homeschooled but not really provided with what we might consider a structured environment. So her ability to overcome and basically teach herself, she ended up going to an Ivy League college. So she has gone again from very humble beginnings to a really high performing academic career.
I think people like those stories of perseverance and overcoming and sort of the underdog achieving in life. And actually, Carol Barrowman, who reviews books for the Milwaukee Journal Sentinel, she's an English professor. She joins us regularly. She mentioned that book in 2018.
Yeah, she's a big fan.
Another one that she mentioned is Where the Crawdads Sing. And I know that's your third book. This is actually one of my book club's picks. And this was on Reese Witherspoon's book club, wasn't
it? Most definitely. And that's another thing that can boost these books is that influencer culture, celebrities that we know, trust, and love. When they recommend something, we know that we're gonna be in good hands with those recommendations. Where the Crawdads Sing is atmospheric. You feel immersed. You feel like you're there. It's also a non-traditional narrative. The chapters are going back and forth in time, so you're hearing this story from two perspectives, so you really are immersed in this world.
That's cool. Okay, the next one is
An American Marriage by T.R.E. Jones, also the Oprah influence with this title.
Okay.
This story is really telling a very modern love story. A couple that's very happy and in love in this great marriage suddenly are torn apart by basically our legal system. And they have to spend these years apart, maintain their relationship. So it is a love story, but maybe not the most traditional happy ending.
She was on our show too in 2018 talking about the book, which is great. That one I think was really popular also for book
clubs. There she is.
Because of some of the, you know, the issues that she hits in the book, which is great.
Rich discussions will come out of that.
And then the last one is Diary of a Wimpy Kid. This brings me back to when my kids especially were in grade school.
We cannot keep these on the shelves. Even though they're not the newest publications, kids absolutely love them. They're funny, they're real, they're telling a story that every kid can identify with. And of course, it has a little bit of that, you know, tween humor. So the jokes sometimes might not be what grown-ups like, but kids are gonna laugh hysterically.
Cute. I love it. How do you kind of, can you predict what's gonna be popular, or can you get any book that you're looking for at the library?
So one of the things that we have a staff that are selectors, they're responsible for following publication trends. So they're tracking reviews, the who's who in the publishing world, and they're trying to predict what these trends are. However, we also respond to what our readers want. It's really important that our selectors have their fingers on the pulse of our communities and neighborhoods to know what books are going to be meaningful to them. So using that blended approach, we're hopefully able to have what you want on the shelves. And in the case of Where the Crawdads Sing, that still has a long holds list.
So
as we see these trends, then we try to buy and support basically what our people are interested in.
I was going to say, if they get a big backing like Reese Witherspoon or Oprah, you know, her book club, then you, I would think you have to go into like stock it mode.
Oh, right. We have to click copies. That order button.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
I love the like the feel of a library book.
Me too.
There's something about it. I think everybody who likes like a tangible book to read, it's like the library books with like this stuff. I just want to like,
the crinkly
stuff. Can't wait. I want to read it all.
Yeah. My favorite is when they have all the photos in that middle. So that's what I was thumbing through before I came out, was looking at all the photos of Michelle Obama.
That's cool. We love it when you're here. Thank you so much for being here. You got to get a library card if you don't have one, or maybe it's gotten a little bit outdated. It's easy to renew it, re-up it. Just bring your driver's license, right? Isn't that all it takes to get a library card?
It's absolutely free.
It's free! MPL.org is the website to visit. Always great to see you.
Thank you.
Thanks, Rachel.
Thank you so much. Still ahead of